Good morning, everybody. Thanks for joining us here on the web. Investigators say they have solved a decades-old cold case murder thanks to DNA evidence. Officials say they have linked convicted killer Edward Mayrand to the killings of two more women, including one here in New Hampshire, even though Mayrand himself is now dead. Mayrand was convicted of killing and dismembering a woman in Rhode Island in the mid-1990s. He had also been suspected of killing a woman in Gardner, Massachusetts in 1983, and then killing Judith Whitney in Winchester, New Hampshire in 1987. But at that time, investigators didn't have enough evidence to move forward. Now, DNA testing has officially linked Mayrand to the Gardner killing, and because of the similarities in the cases, authorities say he was responsible for the New Hampshire murder as well.
Without the DNA finding, you would not be able to draw the comparisons that you do now between what happened to Kathleen Denault and what happened to Judith Whitney. And those comparisons are really the difference maker here.
Investigators say Mayrand's implication in three separate but similar murders by definition makes him a serial killer. The family of the woman killed in Massachusetts says the new findings do provide them with some closure. A man accused of threatening to shoot police officers is due in court today. Police in Bow were called to a home on Birchdale Road just before 9 last night for a reported assault. When officers arrived, they say 46-year-old Timothy Hodgman ran from the home into some woods. After threatening officers and trying to run again, police tased Hodgman and arrested him. He faces several charges, including simple assault and criminal threatening. Right now, Laconia police are looking for the man they say robbed the D'Angelo's restaurant on Union Avenue last night. Police say the man forced his way into the back door just after 9 o'clock when an employee took out the trash. He then grabbed the cash out of the registers and ran off. No weapon was shown and no one was hurt. The executive council has delayed taking action on a proposed $13 million contract with Fairpoint Communications to provide phone and internet service as a labor dispute at that company continues. Under the deal, Fairpoint would provide services to the state until 2020. But the strike in northern New England has caused problems for many customers, and members of the council say they have concerns.
I have been concerned about the labor dispute between Fairpoint and its workers. I am concerned about the impact that that's had on service throughout the state.
You know, before you're going to enter into a $13 million contract with a business, you better be sure they're in a place to be able to deliver on what they say they can.
Fairpoint says it is working to address the council's concerns, and they expect that efforts will be able to move forward next month. That's it for your morning webcast. We'll have an update at around 1 o'clock this afternoon. Have a great day, everybody.